Hi guys, Aris from Slovenia. As it seems, we will also have efficiency ratings for mobile phones and tablets starting June 20, 2025. Scale of energy efficiency classes from A to G. The energy efficiency class of this product, I am describing the label that EU will require from June 20. The battery endurance per cycle in hours and minutes per full battery charge, repeated free fall reliability class. So besides efficiency, EU also cares how tolerant to falls a mobile phone is. The idea behind all of this, I think, it is to of course have the lowest possible power consumption for mobile phones, but also for us to keep longer the mobile phones. So if you keep a mobile phone longer, you don't need so many paths, and in general, you don't need so much resources. Continuing with the description of the label, battery endurance in cycles, repairability class. So mobile phones and tablets also have to be, you also have to be able to repair them. And ingress protection rating, this is the IP rating, how tolerant a mobile device is in liquids and dust and stuff like that. This is all very exciting. Efficiency classes, yeah. I didn't see anywhere how you will be able to measure efficiency. The most popular way is to run a benchmark, a specific benchmark, and measure somehow the power consumption. And then say that, okay, to finish this benchmark, it finished in X time, the power consumption was Y watts. And you do the math there and you get a ratio for energy efficiency. This is one way. The other way, there could also be an energy efficiency for the adapters that we use to charge our mobile phones. But I don't think that this label describes the adapters. So, in my opinion, EU and worldwide, they should also have something for the adapters, because imagine that, millions of adapters sold all over the world, millions. There is no efficiency rating on them. And this is very, very important, because the adapter gets 230 volt, 115 volt, and outputs 5 volt to charge your mobile device. There's no energy efficiency rating for the adapters. This is the most important stuff, if you ask me. What is covered? Okay, smartphones, 4 to 7 inches screens, feature phones, basic mobile phones with no applications, cordless phones. Do you remember the landlines? If you still have a landline and a cordless phone, it is covered as well. Slate tablets. With the word slate, it means tablets with no keyboards. Okay, no attached keyboard. Android and iOS. What is not covered? Tablet computers, Windows-based detachable keyboard, rollable flexible display devices, and high security communication smartphones. And EU says by 2030, this means in 5 years from now, energy savings, 2.2 terawatt hours per year saved. Wow. Equivalent to saving 10 kilowatt hour per household yearly. Cost savings, 20 billion total user savings. 98 euros per household on average. Environmental impact, the most important of all, guys. Longer device lifetime. For example, a mid-range smartphone use is extended from 3 years to 4.1 years. Fewer devices produced and sold, so lower production emissions. Guys, I think that this is good for all of us consumers. It is not good for the manufacturers. Manufacturers must provide printed and electronic energy labels, enter product data into the EU database, include energy class information in advertising and promotional material, provide printed product sheets upon dealer request. Another question now, who will take all these measurements? The manufacturer? Do I trust the manufacturer? The manufacturer might say that, okay, this is an A efficiency class. How you could be sure about that, that it's A, it's not B or C or D? We need an independent organization. And Talking about that, Cybernetics will soon be a certification body for efficiency, and I'm already thinking if we should also include mobile devices in our scope. It is not easy, but it's not tough either. I think it's doable, and we will look into that, because I cannot trust the guys who make a device to also test it and say, hey, that's the official specs, without anybody taking that. If you have any questions, leave them. I will try to reply them, if I know the reply, of course, the answers. And I want to hear your thoughts about this new EU initiative. I think it is very, very interesting, and I'm expecting US to also follow that. Yeah, that's all, guys.